Methods commonly used to study volcanic plumbing systems. Field-based studies of volcanic plumbing systems have initially aimed at a qualitative description of intrusive phenomena and focused on the classification of intrusion lithologies and morphologies to understand how magma is transported, stored, and evolves in the crust. With time, field work has become increasingly quantitative, producing a detailed record of the compositions and structures associated with magmatic intrusions. Analyses of the composition, absolute and relative ages, and dimensions of the components of magmatic plumbing systems have produced a more and more systematic view of the emplacement and evolution of plumbing systems. Besides the recording of variations in lithology and emplacement-related structures, mapping of magmatic intrusions often includes the study of magmatic fabrics recorded within the igneous rocks, such as preferred orientation of phenocrysts and of magnetic minerals using their so-called anisotropy of magnetic susceptibility, AMS. Recently, classical methods, such as field mapping with paper maps and compass, have become complemented by modern digital mapping techniques using global positioning system, GPS, and smartphones, figure 2. At the same time, the possibilities to analyze structural data collected in the field become more and more sophisticated. In addition to thorough statistical analysis and stereographic projection, three-dimensional, 3D, structural modeling is used to visualize, reconstruct, and interpret structural field data. Examples of field and structural studies of volcanic plumbing systems. A. Geological map of the Isle of Rum draped over a digital elevation model. Map modified from Scottish Natural Heritage 1:20,000 map, copyright SNH. B. High-precision GPS mapping of the roof of a granitic pluton, CF. C. Results of 3D reconstruction of a granitic pluton based on GPS mapping. D. Measuring fractures in a granitic intrusion using a smartphone and field move Clino app by Midland Valley Limited. E. Outcrop of basaltic inclined sheets and corresponding projection of poles to orientation planes and density of 321 such sheet intrusions in an equal area, lower hemisphere plot, CF. F. Probability density function, PDF, of the thickness of magmatic sheets, such as shown in, E, compared to a selection of statistical distributions. G. 3D structural model of the plumbing system of the Ardnamurchan Central Complex, Scotland, produced using move by Midland Valley Limited, modified from. Igneous plumbing systems in outcrops regularly extend over several kilometers. Such wide extents represent a substantial challenge for, 1, having a correct overview understanding of the structure of the exposed VPS and, 2, completing structural field surveying in a manageable time. In addition, numerous field areas of interest are hardly reachable for direct observations, such as very steep mountains and crevasses. Recent technologies, including LiDAR scanners, drones, and robots, have recently started overcoming these challenges. On one hand, LiDAR scanners have been used to produce high-precision and high-resolution textured virtual outcrop models. Such digital models allow detailed, quantitative 2D and 3D fracture mapping of extensive, mostly subvertical outcrops. On the other hand, drone surveys combined with photogrammetric tools are very helpful to produce virtual outcrop models and orthorectified images of extensive subhorizontal or gently dipping outcrops, and provide new observational perspectives for extensive structural mapping. Finally, robots equipped with monitoring tools can explore the Earth's interior that is inaccessible for humans. The data produced by these modern tools allow new possibilities for post-field digital mapping of extensive areas, thus shortening the field campaigns. Therefore, field studies of exhumed plumbing systems form the foundation of our conceptual understanding of the individual components of volcanic plumbing systems, their morphologies, sizes, and emplacement mechanisms, as well as of characteristic structures in the host rock associated with the evolution of magmatic intrusions. Field work in eroded volcanic areas is therefore of critical importance, because it provides us with fundamental information that may be used to benchmark numerical and laboratory models, see section 3.5, and to interpret geophysical and geodetic data, see sections 3.3 and 3.4. The main limitation of the field-based approach to study volcanic plumbing systems is that fossil and eroded volcanic plumbing systems represent a snapshot of the final state of the magmatic system only, while active volcanoes do not permit a detailed look inside their VPS. An outcrop in an eroded volcano is essentially a snapshot of the sum of all superimposed processes a suite of rock has experienced. It is thus not always straightforward to extract accurate age relationship between individual units or even distinct boundaries at times, as well as to deduce what dynamic processes were contributing to the final picture. Igneous petrology and geochemistry are among the classic approaches used to characterize volcanic plumbing systems, see also Section 2, and aim to describe the conditions, time scales, and characteristics of the chemical evolution of magma. This characterization is generally based on the mineralogy and textures of igneous rocks, as well as their major and trace element composition, for example Figure 3. In order to study the minerals, textures, and compositions of rock samples collected in the field, igneous petrologists employ a wide range of analytical techniques, which have been developed simultaneously with, and strongly facilitated, an increasing understanding of the chemical evolution of minerals and melts. These analytical techniques have emerged in a rapid succession and have become increasingly precise since igneous petrology was established as a discipline and the first microscopes were built in the second half of the 19th century, see Section 2. Today, rock textures and the type and associations of minerals in thin sections of rock samples are studied using a variety of microscopes. The bulk, or whole rock, composition of an igneous rock that mostly comprises the quantity of major elements or their oxides can be derived through, for example, exposing a powdered sample of a rock to X-rays, X-ray fluorescence, XRF. Other analytical techniques, such as mass spectrometry, can quantify the isotopic composition of the major and trace elements of a sample. Data on the mineralogy and composition of igneous rocks are probes into the chemical evolution of volcanic plumbing systems and can be used in many ways. In many cases, the whole rock composition is characteristic of the geodynamic setting and origin of the magma and can also be used to discriminate processes in the plumbing system, such as fractional crystallization, for example. The concentration of trace elements can be used in geochemical modeling to quantify processes in the volcanic plumbing system, such as assimilation of country rocks into the magma, for example. The decay of radiogenic isotopes is used as a standard tool to determine the absolute age of a rock sample, which has led to detailed insights into the time scales of magma emplacement in volcanic plumbing systems, for example. At the scale of individual crystals, crystal size distributions, chemical zoning, and textures can serve as records of the chemical and thermal evolution of their host magmas, for example. Crystal growth rates and chemical diffusion across crystal zones can furthermore be used to quantify the time scales of, for example, magma storage or replenishment, for example. Moreover, pressure and/or temperature-dependent mineral compositions can be used as so-called geobarometers and/or geothermometers that reveal the depth and conditions at which certain minerals grew, which usually corresponds to magma reservoir depth, for example. In order to quantify the chemical evolution of minerals and magmas in situ, petrological experiments are used to simulate, for example, the influence of pressure and/or temperature on mineral compositions and the reaction of magma with crustal rocks. Petrological and geochemical studies of volcanic plumbing systems are thus the foundation of our understanding of the chemical and thermal processes during magma storage and offer insight into the time scales of magma transport and evolution. Estimates of the depth of magma storage provide valuable constraints on the interpretation of geodetic and geophysical monitoring data of active volcanoes, see sections 3.3 and 3.4. Furthermore, a characterization of the types of magma erupted from a volcano and an understanding of the processes of magma evolution in the plumbing system allow evaluating the probable type of eruption in the future. The main limitation of the petrological and geochemical approaches is that magma samples from active volcanic plumbing systems are generally not available. Although many of the processes of magma evolution can be constrained based on petrological experiments, the major and trace element compositions of rocks and minerals can in many cases not be attributed to any specific process. The contribution of each individual process is often difficult to quantify. Moreover, the insights derived from petrological and geochemical approaches apply to the geological past of the plumbing system only. It is therefore not always straightforward to conclude on the present state.